Okay, so welcome. Our webinar, you can see the topic there, or the title is How to Invest Your Retirement Tax Efficiently, or How to Invest for Your Retirement Tax Efficiently. And you can see the subtitle there is Read My Lips, No New Taxes. And those of you who have been around for a while, remember that is a very important one little line taken out of a speech. And that was a pledge, as I say, the center speech from George George H.W. Bush, this, in other words, senior. It was his acceptance address way back in 1988. So obviously it's a strong and decisive and bold statement. And as you would know, is that again, as you would tell us that Bush actually raised taxes. Okay, so his words actually came back and was used against him by then Arkansas Governor Bill Clinton, which obviously used as a devastating attack way back in 1992 with the presidential campaign. Okay, so yes, I'm focusing on, we're going to talk about taxes and things like that, but obviously that's not the sole focus. And you'll see the next slide, this is a bit of a tongue-in-cheek. This is a advert that was running for a while from Morgan Stanley. It says you must pay taxes, but there's no law that says you've got to leave a tip. Okay, so my objective here is that obviously there's a big difference between tax avoidance, you know, in the sense that you pay what is due. Obviously, you want to try and get as much as you can legally as compared to tax evasion, which is obviously illegal. But my argument today, or my point of my presentation, is take advantage of where you can. And the current situation for a lot of people, as I say, is they're not taking advantage of it. People are not taking advantage in the sense that if you look at these two little images, you're throwing away money, or you're missing opportunities. That's the two way of looking at it. So that's the current situation for a lot of people. I mean, most people won't know the opportunity available for them. So we're talking about today is investors should consider the impact of tax when planning for their retirement. But although that should not be your primary concern, obviously things like growth and performance and risk is also important. But saying that, having a tax-efficient investment vehicle is essential to maximizing your returns. Okay. So tax efficiency, what I mean by that, it's just a measure of how much of your investment return is left after taxes are paid. So what we're going to talk about today is the tax-free savings plan or tax-free investment plan, which offers an instant way for you as an investor to supplement the structured retirement savings. When I say that structured retirement savings, this is after your pension and your provident fund contributions and obviously your retirement annuities. I would say this is where the tax-free would fit in. Because remember, those structured retirement savings, the big benefit there is that your contributions are tax-deductible, number one, and number two, when it comes to payout, your first third is tax-free, and then the other two thirds has to be invested for annuity income, but also the tax rates are more favorable. So your tax-free investment plan fits in after all those kind of investments. I hope that makes sense to you guys. Okay, so what is the ideal situation, ideal position to be in? And yeah, it's common sense, but yes, obviously you want to go for a vehicle that's going to help you build up a nest egg for retirement. You want to have sufficient retirement savings. I think that's obvious point to make. But my point I'm trying to make today also, you want to maximize the growth and help your retirement savings grow. So that's the ideal situation you want to be in. How do we get there? So, as I say, we're talking about the tax-free investment plan. Those of you that don't know what it's about, it's just a vehicle for you as an investor to save more. The Treasury hopes that with the tax-free investment savings plan to help reduce financial vulnerability of obviously individuals, number one, and number two, obviously to reduce household indebtedness. So the whole idea is that hopefully they also want to raise the overall savings levels in the country, which will obviously improve as a result of people investing in this product. The main thing here is that obviously, as we're implied, tax-free. You pay no tax on your investment growth. In other words, you save without paying the free taxes. What I mean by that is income tax on interest, dividend tax, as well as obviously capital gains tax. Those are the three big taxes that you'll be saving on. Also, when you take your money out, obviously you won't be paying any taxes on those kind of things. That's a very, I like it, it's a very simple product to understand. There's no complications from a tax point of view. What I also like about it, there's no restrictions on withdrawals. You can withdraw whatever you want to. So it's a nice savings vehicle. Okay. But it's obviously advisable, and we'll talk about it a bit later, that you, that your goal is to remain invested for at least 3 to 5 years. Okay, that's where the growth starts kicking in and start taking advantage of compounding and things like that. Now, the big thing about this tax-free investment plan, the product, you have flexibility of contributions. So if things get a bit tight, you suspend your contributions, and so you got that flexibility. Okay. What are the contributions? So this is where it does get a bit, call it, complex. Just understand that contributions are made from post-tax income, number one, and number two is that the National Treasury has put limits on the amount of that you can save in this tax-free investment plan. So first of all, the annual contribution is limited to 30,000 a year divided by 12, which is maximum of 2,500 rand per month. Okay. Then also you have a lifetime contribution limit, which is 500,000 rand. So divide that by your 30,000 annual contribution, you find that it works out about 200 months, which is roughly about 16.7 years. Okay. You can't put any contributions over those limits. If you do go over those limits, there is a penalty. And anything over that limit, over that 30,000 annual limit, you'll be taxed at 40%. Yeah, so just understand that there are penalties. But it's also important to understand that there's no limit to how many tax-free savings plans you can have. You know? Make sure that your annual payments across all the approved tax savings accounts do not exceed that annual tax contribution. You know, end of the year, we provide you with IT3S, which is just donating that obviously your contributions to the tax-free plan. But it's also linked to all your other funds. So obviously, Old Mutual, for example, also said in the IT3S on your behalf. Okay, so I just want to grab water. By the way, a tax year, South African tax year runs from the 1st of March to the 28th of February of the next year. So we now, in obviously the 25th of January, you still got until the end of February to contribute for this year to take advantage of the tax-free contribution, call it limit. Okay, so you can still put in your 30,000. And we'll talk about one of the ways just now, one of the ways the clients mentioned to me yesterday. I thought it was quite a clever way of doing it. Okay, so other features of the tax-free investment plan. Please understand this is only for a natural person. In other words, you can also open a tax-free investment plan for your children. Just understand that you will be using up their savings on their behalf. Okay, I don't think they'll complain. But just understand that you are taking up some of the tax-free plan. So no trust, no companies, no investment trusts, investment clubs and things like that. It's only for individuals. That's number one. And number two, very importantly, only South African citizens can apply for this tax-free investment plan. Okay? So I mentioned just now, obviously, you can have numerous plans across all the different service providers. You need to keep track of how much you're investing. Don't go over the annual limit. Okay. What are the underlying instruments or the products that qualify? There's a whole range of unit trusts that are included. Remember, we're just wrapping it up in a tax efficient vehicle. So what's included in those in that list is about 94 funds. You'll see in the next slide or so where you'll be able to find that list. It's about 94 funds you can choose from all the different providers. But any of those products do not include performance fees. Okay, so performance fees are not allowed. This makes it simpler for you as an investor. So structured products are also not allowed. and also direct share purchases are allowed. In other words, you can't transfer a share, buy a share and transfer it into this tax-free investment plan. Okay. And also conversion of existing investor products. For example, you might have what we call voluntary investment plan or unit trusts. Exactly the same scenario that it might be included in the tax-free plan. You can't transfer it across. But what I've seen, what some of the clients are doing is that obviously they're selling out as long as it doesn't, capital gains is less than 40,000. You can take 30,000, transfer or sell out your VIP and then transfer into your tax-free plan. Okay, that's how the guys are using it. Exactly the same fund, obviously now being wrapped up in this kind of vehicle. Okay, so the big differences I want to make a highlight again is the if you compare to a normal voluntary investment plan. Remember, all the different taxes you do not pay in a tax-free investment plan. So there's no tax on capital gains tax, no 50% holdings tax, and no income tax. Where in a normal voluntary investment plan, it works on what they call an inclusion rate. So at this point in time, it's 40% of the maximum, which is 41%. In this scenario, you can pay up to 16.4% capital gains. Obviously, your first 40,000 of gains is excluded, and obviously from there you'll be paying your tax on that. In a normal voluntary investment plan, you're paying 15% dividend tax, and obviously also you're getting a bit of exemption on the interest fee. But just as I say, on the tax free, it's just simple. There's no tax involved. Yeah. So the easiest way to explain this is by way of an example. So you have made some assumptions. Okay, we're going to take, let me bring you my little, call it cursor, my spotlight. Okay, so we're going to go, I'm using a simple 10% compound annual rate of return, working on 6% inflation, maximum contributions for the year is 30%. My total year, this is going for the full term, remember I said to you it's 200 months or 16.7 years. My allocation, I'm allocating most of the funds 70% to equities and 30% to fixed income. Okay, I'm working on a 3% dividend yield. And you can see our inclusion rate, as I say, working on maximum 40%, dividend tax 15%, so it goes on. I want to compare, if I invested in a normal unit trust and the same unit trust wrapped up in a tax-free plan, what would be the differences? And I want to highlight the big differences for you. Okay. So go to the next slide. So you can get rid of my cursor here again. The main thing I want to highlight for you guys is that you see here, if you had to compare the proceeds from a tax-free, remember the proceeds from a tax-free investment plan is 100% tax-free. So yeah, I'm using an example of a discretionary investor that has a marginal tax rate of 31%. Let me get my cursor back here again. Okay, there we go, 31%. After contributing 30,000 rand per year and growth rate of 10% compounded, after is 16.7 years, you're accumulated 1,120,000, just over 120,000 rand. Okay, but from that, you still have to pay dividend withholding tax, as well as interest on tax, as well as the capital gains liability. So that equates the difference. The same scenario you can see there. The difference here is 169,000 rand you'd save investing in the same unit trust if it was just wrapped up in the tax-free investment plan. That equates to on a 31% marginal tax rate of a saving or a gain of 15.16%. Okay, so that's on a marginal tax rate of 31%. If you look at our example here, it's a big difference. Okay, so you move up the scale, the higher marginal tax rate, okay, you see that, geez, we're saving here 19.8% if you're on a marginal tax rate of 41%. Okay, 210,000 rand you'll be saving. Okay, let's move to the next slide. So, just in a graph format, you can see the difference here now. You can see the big difference. As obviously the marginal tax increases, the difference between what you are receiving in a voluntary investment plan compared to tax-free is amazing. Okay. So, yeah, with ordinary investment, the person is paying a maximum marginal tax rate of 41%. So, say, you can be, the difference between those two there, bring my little cursor in again, is just over 19%. Okay. That there, 19%, which is a big difference. So, you're missing out on that opportunity. So, the benefits of the tax-free savings account are real. That's my point I'm trying to make here. Especially if the investment is kept for the longer term, insofar as maximizing the tax benefits, number one, and number two, using the compounding effect thereof, which is obviously giving you sufficient time to take advantage of, to work its magic, in other words. So I hope that gets the point across. Same funds, just wrapped up in a tax-free investment plan is a big, big saving. So that's the incentive that you have. Okay. So what are the benefits? What will this do for you? Excuse me. So the main benefit here, you can use this as a vehicle or as a savings product to supplement your retirement savings, number one. Number two, save for your children's education. Remember, we're talking about 16 years, 16.7 years from university fees and things like that. If they're just born now, 5, 6, 7 years' time, obviously using it for their school fees and that. Okay. But also for emergencies. I think it's a great vehicle for emergencies. Maybe you can get hold of the funds straight away. And also just increase our general savings. You know, if you want to plan for overseas holiday, or I call it, if you want to do a cooking course or a wine tasting course, this is what you want to do it for. You know, so that's what the main benefits, I think, that you'll gain from it. Just also remember the contributions, the benefits from that. You have the flexibility of contributions. So you can start and stop your contributions at any time, obviously within those limits. So I stop and I will start contributing again as long as I don't exceed my 30,000 annual contribution limit. Okay, so remember, minimum lump sum from a lump sum investment is 6,000 Rand that PSG World accepts. From a debit order point of view, our minimum monthly debit order is 500 Rand per month. Because remember, the advantage there, obviously, is Rand cost averaging. So that's the advantage of the debit order. Okay. So say you got a wide range of funds to choose from. You'll see on the next slide anyway where you'll get the link from. But you can just go onto our website. And you'll see that's the fund list specifically that qualify for the tax-free investment plan. Remember, it's only clean classes that are offered in that scenario. When I say clean classes, it's no performance fees. If you are withdrawal from those funds, there's no exit fees. Okay. You can set up, obviously, automatic annual premium increases as long as it doesn't exceed that 30,000 annual limit. Okay. So, you might be saying it's a great idea, but you might have some consideration. So the main thing is, what are available? As I say, I don't want to go into too much detail now. Cassandra last week did a very good webinar on the tools available. We've got 4 different tools. But yeah, that's where you can click on one of the tools, gives you the list available. You can see what funds are available. From there, I suggest you go to the funds list A to Z, and it helps you with performance and fees and risk and things like that, and obviously also the EAL calculator, which we explained last week's webinar. So refer back to that in the archive. Okay. Again, when it comes to fees, consider PSG funds, because remember, on our funds, we only charge you an ongoing fee of 0.2% with that. That's per annum. Okay, so our fees are very competitive. Other unit trust, it's a sliding scale. The first 1.5 million is 1.5%. Anything above that then would slide down to 0.228%. Okay. So consider, go look at our list. As I say, there's a list, the link down here also to our funds A to Z list. You can look at performances and things like that. Okay. So guys, let me see what kind of questions you have. And we'll take it from there. Okay. We still got some time this time with questions. Awesome. Okay. Okay, cool. Let me see the question here. If I invest 30,000 in February 2017, will I be able to invest another 30,000 in March? Yes, Okay, Leon, that's a good question. So that's how I'm saying you've still got that window now to take advantage of this tax year for that 30,000 until the 28th of February next month. And that contributes for the 2016 to 2017 year. From March onwards, obviously, that's 2017-2018 year. Okay. Okay. There's a correction here from Quibus. Sorry, I said the first third is tax-free. That's your first 500,000 is tax-free in the retirement annuity tax-free. Sorry, I need to elaborate on that. Okay. Martin, you're welcome to drop me an email. Who do I contact about investing at PSG? I'll be your contact person. You'll see my contact details at the end of this presentation anyway. Okay, Martin, I've got your email. I can always contact you too. How can I make sure you don't exceed my 500,000 lifetime limit? So as long as you keep your contributions to less than 30,000 per year, Willem, the IT3S that we sent out will highlight it for you. Okay, but obviously you need to take owners, take responsibility for yourself and make sure you don't exceed that 30,000 annual limit. Okay, let me see what other questions I got here. There's a question from Colin Walter. Okay, good question. Says, it's quite a long question here. So I'm a 67-year-old and retired for two years. Should I be investing in a tax-free investment plan in my present position, or should I look elsewhere? Good question, Colin. And my answer to you would be most definitely, if you have the opportunity to invest in tax-free, you should utilize the opportunity irrespective of your age. Okay. Main thing what you want to do there, remember it's the growth is tax-free. So use the opportunity to save for that holiday or that food tasting course you want to do, etc. Okay. Is there a minimum investment period? I mentioned just now, ideally you should be going for a bit longer term, 3 to 5 years. But obviously in retirement, you want to maximize growth as much as you can. So it depends on your asset allocation. If you're looking at high equity funds, you'd be looking at a minimum investment period of, I would say, 7 years that'll best suit your investment criteria there. Less than that, if you're looking at income, 3 years, if you want to use the tax-free investment plan for that, then go for it. But obviously, you're still susceptible for the short-term volatility risk and those kind of things. And also, as well as capital, depends on what happens on the market. There's no guarantees your market-related performances. So you need to keep your eye on the ball. Okay, so yes, shorter-term investments, you can look at the money market income funds, which is a bit more lower risk, but also obviously lower returns. I think they're giving around about 6 to 8%. Okay. Another question here. On my tax form, where do I fill this out? Remember, you'll be getting an IT3, what's it called? IT3S statement back from PSG Wealth, and that obviously you'll be using as a record of your contributions to this fund. Okay. Remember, if you take any money out, remember it's tax free. So I hope that answers your question. Can I transfer? There's a question here. Can I transfer my existing VIP to my tax-free investment plan? No, as I say, no. What you can do is that you can sell out, and as long as the profit is below the 40,000, remember capital gains is your first 40,000 is tax-free, you can use that and then obviously complete the withdrawal form. And I think where it says provide the bank details, you provide the PSG investment bank details, and obviously you referred us, PSG Wealth, to that as proof of payment. And then you can transfer those proceeds into your tax-free investment plan. Okay, that's one way of using it. Okay. Quibus, is there a chance of a 500,000 limit being increased over the next few years? We'll see. Obviously, the big thing now, we're coming up to the budget speech, they're talking about increasing taxes and things like that. So we don't know. We'll see. We hope so. It's a great little investment vehicle. Okay, I hope that answers your question. I wouldn't know. We have to look forward to our budget speech, Quibus. Okay. We have a long question here from Shante. Would you be able to provide us with a comparison between potential returns between a retirement annuity and a tax-free investment like I did with the comparison. Okay. Yeah, I can follow that up with, I can ask people to do it, and maybe we can include it in next week's presentation, or sorry, the 8th of February is our next presentation. Good point. We can do that there. Okay. Say after 5 years, sorry, after 7 years, the question here from Mukeshi. Say after 7 years, should we leave the monies into the tax-free plan or move into a better plan? Okay, first of all, from a tax point of view, there's no better plan. Okay, as I say, all tax on capital gains and all that is tax-free. So you might want to switch between the different funds and things like that within the tax-free investment plans to for better growth. But better than there's no better product from a tax point of view. Okay, because remember, as I say, there's no, you don't pay any taxes. I hope that answers your question too. Okay, looks like it's all the questions going through. Yeah. Will my withdrawals and a tax-free investment affect my retirement annuity withdrawals? No. Okay, that's going to have you do two separate things. Remember, your tax-free investment withdrawals there are tax-free. Retirement annuity, your first, when you get to the right retirement age, obviously 55, you can, as I say, withdraw up to the first 500,000 tax-free. But that's got nothing to do with your living into annuities and things like that. These are additional incomes. That's why I say you want to supplement your RAs and pension funds and things like that. Okay. Cool. Guys, thanks for all the questions. I appreciate it. Okay. That's in conclusion. What I want you to remember from this presentation, remember it's an investment product geared for growth. Just take advantage of the tax alone, and the potential you got there and the savings you got there obviously is a big benefit. So this product is tailored to your individual needs and risk tolerance. As I say, look at all the funds available, and you can switch between the funds every year and things like that. Yeah. It's a unique advantage in the sense that it offers you tax-free investment returns on your growth and dividends and things like that. Another big benefit I want you to take away from, just understand that, yes, it's limited to 30,000 per year and 500,000 at this point in time, but remember, utilize that. And you say excuse me, there's still a month to go to utilize for this year if you haven't used it as yet. And that leads on to my next point. What are your next action steps? If you haven't got a tax-free investment plan as yet, please go register. Click on that little link there, go register, open up the account. If we've got your account, if you've got an account with us already, as longer than 3 months, you just have to do a proof of payment, a proof of bank, and a proof of residence. Usually your bank statement does both of them for us. As I said, the webinar and the recording will be sent to you guys. And I really appreciate any feedback from you guys regarding this webinar and future webinars. Okay. There's our contact email address, wealth@phg.co.za. Comes to us on the desk there. So if you guys need any help regarding investments, we're there to help you. And there's our number to get hold of us. Okay. But thanks from my side for being on this webinar. Next week, or sorry, the 8th of February, the topic will be time is running out to save tax now. So yes, we're talking about tax-free and also as well as the retirement annuities. And that's where I think we'll be talking that comparison. Okay. And in the 22nd, you notice how we're trying a little experiment here. We do webinars every 2 weeks. On the 22nd of February, we're talking about how to use derivatives to your advantage. Those of you that were around in December, we tried to do this webinar in December. We had some technical difficulties. This will be a repeat of that webinar. Okay. But people, thank you very much for being on this webinar. There's my direct email address. And then obviously our switchboard number and things like that. But thanks for being on this webinar. Until 2 weeks' time, keep well and bye for now.